Shalom Saints, welcome to Heart of Worship with Sarah Yao. I'm very excited again for this session that we are having today, and I would like to talk about the heavenly worship. Now, why this subject of heavenly worship? Because when Jesus taught his disciples how to pray, one of the elements of the prayer was, let your kingdom come and let your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Now, this is actually very big. The heart of Abba Father is for his will to be done on earth, how? As it is in heaven. So we are to worship the Lord as it is in heaven. Now, when we look at the worship songs of our days, many of them have long structures and many words, but not the heavenly worship. And I would like to draw your attention to that. In the book of Isaiah chapter 6, the Bible talks about an encounter that Isaiah had. He said, I saw the Lord seated on the throne, high and lifted up. And in the encounter that he had, he actually saw angels worshiping. The Bible talks about the seraphim. And what did they say in the worship? Was there a verse and a chorus and a second verse and a bridge? And an outro? No. The Bible says, they said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. The whole earth is filled with his glory. Wow. The Lord is not seeking our many words. He's seeking the truth in what we are saying. Now, I'm not against words. I'm also a songwriter, and I believe we can write as the Spirit lead. But true, genuine worship is not in the many words. The words are a tool. And many times our flesh gets bored. How many of you can say, holy, holy, holy for 30 minutes without thinking, I'm tired about this now, I don't want to do it anymore. But that's the attitude of the flesh. Now, in heaven, the flesh does not interfere. So in Revelation chapter 4, we also read about the heavenly worship. And again, the same word, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Now, how powerful is that? Now, holy has many meanings, but one of the meanings is different. Now, these are beings that constantly see the Lord, and every time they see him is different. There is another facet of him. There is another manifestation of who he is. So every time they see holy, and the next second holy, how powerful is that? So when we are bound to the many words, it means we are still seeking that revelation of the Lord. And worship grows as you grow in your knowledge of the Lord. And that's why the heavenly worship is so, in few words, but glorious. Your worship could be hallelujah, highest praise to Yahweh. But do you mean it? What does it mean? When you say, let your name be exalted, what does it mean? Next time you spend time in worship before the Lord, think about this. Like, what is my worship about? Is it about many words? I think in our congregation, one thing we've experienced is we start with songs, with structures, verses and everything. But then we allow the revelation that Holy Spirit is giving us to give us a new song. This is how we give a new song unto the Lord, by allowing a fresh revelation from the Lord. Unless you receive a new revelation, your worship cannot grow and you will be stagnant. So today I want us to have that longing and that striving to know the Lord even more, so that our worship is not in the many words, but it's in the knowing him. It's in beholding the beauty of holiness. Hallelujah. So we're going to worship now, and I want you to be just free. You don't have to follow what I say. You can also do your own words. You can bring your own melody to the Lord. Oh, 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 I want to know you. I want to know you, Lord. I want to know you more and more. I want to know you. I want to know you. I want to know you more and more. Jesus, lover of my soul. Jesus, lover of my soul. You keep on pursuing, you keep on reaching. Jesus, lover of my soul. Your love is pursuing, your love is reaching. Never stop pursuing, oh Jesus. Oh, 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 hey. I want to know you. That's the desire of my heart. I want to know you, to know you as you are. I want to know you, Lord, to know you as you are. I want to know you more and more. Show me your face. Show me your face, Lord. Show me your face. I want to know you. Show me your face. Show me your face. Show me your face. I want to know you. 'Cause nothing can satisfy my heart. Nothing can satisfy my heart but to know you. Yes, to know you, Lord. Nothing can satisfy my heart. Nothing can satisfy my heart but to know you. I want to know you. Show me your face. Show me your face. You are beautiful. Show me your face, Jesus. Show me your face, 'cause you are beautiful. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Give us a fresh revelation of who you are. We want to behold you with unveiled faces, to truly behold your beauty, to behold your grace, to behold your mercy, to behold the love that passes all understanding, to behold your authority, to behold your might and your power. For you are God, and there is none beside you. So may your worship grow as you grow in the knowledge of Him and practice the heavenly worship by just focusing on the one aspect where you have a revelation and let it take over, and you will see what the Lord will do. So may God bless you, and see you next time.